All right. Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of The Scenic Route, Volume 2, Exploring Botania. How are you guys doing today? I am super, super happy to be here back in our modded Minecraft world. And check out our crops growing. They are looking fantastic out here. They are really very colorful and just a wonderful, wonderful mod from Pam's Harvest Craft. Yeah, very, very cool. Although it is a bummer, I went to go contribute to her Patreon. I wanted to just leave a little donation. I left a little donation for Vazkii, for Quark and Botania. You know, it helps out, man. People make these crazy mods that are just like games unto themselves, you know, and it's cool. If I have a few bucks laying around, which, you know, isn't often, as most of us know, but if I have a few bucks laying around, I like to at least give a little something to the artists that make things, you know, and that probably stems from my being a filmmaker and seeing how hard it is for people to make money when they, it's hard for any artist to make money, you know, so a buck or two doesn't help too much, but yeah, you know, if it can buy you a hot chocolate or buy you a beer, you know, one or the other, it's maybe it's well spent. I was going to say, though, it is kind of a bummer, though. I went and looked at some of Pam's, I don't know if her name is actually Pam. But I went and looked at some of her, to her website or whatever, and it turns out that she might, I guess, suffer from depression, which is really, really a bummer. I mean, depression is, I mean, I know a few people that suffer from such a thing, and, it sucks, you know, it really is, you know, obviously it sucks, right? If you, you know, it's sometimes I think it's hard for those of us who don't have depression or suffer from the same thing to really understand, like, how that's a thing, like, how such a thing can, you know, how can a person actually, you know, it's hard for us to relate. You know, it's always hard to relate to things that we don't actually experience ourselves. That's a tricky thing. You know, I feel bad for Pam if she suffers from that. I feel bad for anybody who suffers from depression, because that's just a bummer in more ways than one. So we got a few things to talk about today, because I have done a couple of things off camera. So as you can see here, we got a new new buddy up here. I have not named our horse, but I did find some diamond armor, and I found the horses and a diamond and the diamond armor. Let's take a look at our journey map, and I'll show you. I've done some exploring, as you can see. I've done some exploring and some labeling of different things that I found. I haven't found any really unique biomes from Biomes of Plenty yet. There's an Outback, I think, biome. So, yeah, so we found 6 more roguelike dungeons, which is pretty crazy. We're never going to explore all those dungeons. That's just craziness. But there's tons and tons of them all over the place. But there are cool structures, and I do want to... I'll show you those real quick where I went, and we'll take a quick photographic tour, like a vacation tour of where I went. We'll take a trip, and we'll go visit the... We'll look for some blacksmiths, because, you know, I added souped-up loot tables to this mod pack, and I can show you what those are. And they're super overpowered. You know, we can find some pretty crazy stuff in them. I can upload those loot tables for you if you'd like as a download. You can add them to your world as well. Loot tables are world-based, and they're just JSON files, and they're pretty easy to manipulate. And as a test, again, this whole world is an experiment, so as a test, I went ahead and... I used some of the loot tables I used in the first series of the Scenic Route. So anyway, let's jump over. Let's check out the places where I went. Let's see what I saw. Look, I just saw we have llamas here. So that's pretty rad. I'm not sure if I leave the area, if they're going to despawn or whatever. I'm not sure how that works. But it's pretty interesting that they spawn here, because I don't think this isn't extreme hills or anything. I'm not sure what the other biomes are that they spawn in, but here is that biome, the outback. Yeah, this is pretty cool. It's a very nice biome, very contrasty with the orange and the green. I think it works really well. I think it's nice. Definitely a nice old west feel to it. We could definitely build something exciting out here. You know, not elven, maybe not elven looking. Maybe something more Steve made or whatever, but yeah, let's see. I don't know if there's a library here. Of course, we're always looking for librarians, right? Or let's see if we have any blacksmiths. Blacksmiths are the ones that have the chests in them, correct? I believe. So let's see. They got a church. So we could, yeah, that's pretty cool. Oh, they do have a blacksmith. It's right here. There's probably a chest in here. Yeah, I bet there is. There's no door. There's a chest. Ah-ha-ha, there you go. How's that for some overpowered loot tables, right? Overpowered loot. Well, you know, modded is essentially all about... Man, we will take all of these. Efficiency 5, we will take that too. Basically, what I've determined is that modded is really about making things a little bit easier. You know, even the mods that profess not to make things super easy, they still... A lot of them have things that do make things easier. There's a librarian, and is he trapped in here? Do we have any blocks? I don't even have any blocks. Let me grab a couple of dirt blocks just if I feel like we want to trap this guy in here. If we need to preserve him for any reason. Let's put a block there, and let's talk to you, sir. What have you got? Feather falling 2, that is not too bad. We'll preserve this gentleman here because... Well, just because. You never know what his other trades might be. So that's this little village here. And then, of course, it's got the roguelike dungeons over here, which are going to be very, very similar to the one that we already have in spawn. But it's a cool little structure. Let's jump over to roguelike dungeon number 3 and see what that one looked like. It's kind of interesting to me that a couple of these roguelike dungeons, at least 3 of them, they all, like every village that we've found so far in this world has a roguelike dungeon very close by. And look at this. This is an awesome Taiga village, right? I love these villages. The dark wood, the spruce wood looks really good with the cobble. And I just think, yeah, it's pretty cool. So let's see if they have do they got anything here that we can go shopping at and see if they have anything fun like a blacksmith? Come on, man. Where's the blacksmith? Everybody needs a blacksmith, right? They do have a, looks like they got a library. Oh, this must be the one that I did actually inspect. Let's see here. Protection 3, not bad at all. And also, that's a good trade for paper right there. So let's push you back in there, sir, so you stay. There we go. You're nice and safe and sound. Nice little desert village. It's got that really cool roguelike dungeon right there. And I think I found 2 of these guys, and that's a really cool structure as well. But I did want to point out something else here, and you can see the terrain shift here. We have a desert right here, and then it borders on a snowy biome. That's the option here where if you're going to make a new world... Let's recreate this one. When you go into customize the biome, it's temperature and rainfall random. So I believe if you set this to latitude or to zones, it will actually make it more logical in the way that the terrain generates so that you don't get necessarily a desert biome right next to a snowy biome. I don't know. I randomized it just because I thought it'd be cool to have chances to see all the biomes that are possible. Look at this. We got some sand up here. We got... Come here, you. No, we don't want that. But let's see. I believe there is a... Yep, there's a blacksmith here that I think I actually found when I originally encountered this village. I don't think I took the things out of it. Let's see what we've got in here. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And check this out. Let's see if this function works here. Villagers in with Quark are supposed to follow... Oh, no, they're supposed to follow an emerald block. Oh, and what have you got? Cartographer. Very nice. Oh, we have to unlock him, so we need some more paper. All right, cool. We know there's a cartographer here. At least zombies haven't killed him. We could get him to come inside of one of these guys here. We would be in good shape. There's no... Thought there was a crafting bench here. Make some of these here. Now watch. Look at that. Yes. Yes. They chase the emerald block. All right. It's just like a cow with wheat. And that is a setting in Quark. Look it. We can gather them all up. Oh, did I lose these guys? I went too far away. Okay. Very cool, though. And I think the cooldown works just like with the animals. So that is very, very handy, is it not? Yes, it is. We're going to take this stuff. Ooh, yeah, we're doing really good on the books there. We'll take this stuff here, and you know what we're going to do? We're going to leave all of our junk in here because we just don't need it right now. On to the next exotic locale. All right, would you guys look at this? This is pretty epic. I thought this was a very cool construction. I did not explore this at all. I just saw it through the trees. And it's pretty rad. It almost reminds me of a Jagiero build a little bit, but his are much more intricate. But yeah, this is super tall. I really like this. This is a very cool structure. When you see it from far away, it's pretty impressive. Wow, this is very cool. I like it. I like it. All kinds of vines. Very neat. In fact, maybe we'll... I don't have any... Oh, I got this. Yeah, maybe I'll go ahead and mine up some vines while we're here, because I didn't do that before. And yeah, I could just pick up a few, because they can become very handy. All right, yeah, and this is the one. This is the one that I did raid and pulled a bunch of stuff out of, all that stuff I showed you, all those ender pearls and everything. I don't think there's anything I left in here. I think I had room to pull everything out that I needed to. There is another suit of diamond horse armor, but yeah, this is junk I left in here that I don't think we need. And this one's pretty cool, right? I mean, it's right on the edge again at the desert. I thought this one was in a really rad location. It's in a desert, obviously. We've got palm trees over there, which I haven't collected any palm wood either yet. But this desert biome sort of wraps into and is wrapped around by a couple of different biomes, like this one here, which is coniferous forest. So this is more of the fir trees, but it doesn't have this. Oh, it's not snowy coniferous forest. Let's go in here. This is really great, surrounded by the green grass and everything. Oh, it's very cool. And what do we have here terrain-wise? Biome-wise, we are in woodland. Huh, woodland is cool. Yeah, it's very green. I definitely like this. Look at that. Got a little entranceway in the back there. We'll drop around here to the front door. And yeah, I guess we have to carve ourselves a way down like I did in the other one. There we go. All right, so we picked everything up here. So let's, you guys prepared to be completely overwhelmed by the by the crazy loot that's about to happen here. Let's see what we got here. All right, some of those. Oh, leather. That's very, very handy. And gold. There we go. Oh man, wow. But no armor or books. That's a little bit disappointing. Not to be greedy or anything, you know. But yeah, that's fine. We'll take the stuff we've got, and we will head back. All right, so back from our little tour around the world. I've been doing some research. I've been reading that lexicon here, and I've been reading it offline and stuff. And it's kind of funny because I've been literally doing homework. I've been studying the lexicon a little bit, and let me let you in on a little secret here. CryinMo is not. CryinMo is not the best student. No, I am not. Basically, when I went to university when I went to college, I did a couple years of college to collect my GI Bill from the military, but I ended up not finishing, and this is probably a bad thing because I'm a horrible role model. Nobody should ever do what I do. As you know, I wanted to take the classes I wanted to take and study the things I wanted to study, but they constantly made me, they kept telling me I had to take things that they wanted me to take, you know, like calculus. I wanted to take creative writing classes, and I wanted to take, you know, narrative and screenwriting and stuff like that. And they were like, well, in order to take those, you got to take these other classes. And I was like, oh, that's just nonsense. So I'm out of here. But that's what I do. That's a CryinMo thing, is I sort of a zone out and will research things that I want to research or that I'm into at any given moment. And then I'll read up on them and I'll study them and I'll do whatever. So, as a example of why you should never do or pay attention to CryinMo and don't do what he does is, because, you know, right now I'm studying Botania. I'm studying a Minecraft mod. And it's just to learn how to play the thing. The thing I've been finding out is that it is like other mods, that it does have ways to create automation and things like that, and to make things easier. But look at this really quick. What did I do with those ender pearls? I want to show you one of the things from the Quark mod. Obviously, you guys that play the Quark mod, you'll know, you're all familiar with these. Check this out. Whoa, special arrows. And do they stack? Yes, they do. I think. Oh, that's so cool. I found a vein of marble, which is pretty cool. That's a quark block, I think. And it's kind of an interesting block here, you know, like that. We can also do, let's see, what does that give us? Polished marble. I know we can make a wall version. Look at that. I bet we can even do it with this. Yeah, we can make a marble brick wall. So look at that. This is the range of blocks we can make just with one item, one block item from Quark. Check out this living rock. That's kind of a neat block. I think that's pretty cool, and I don't know what else we can do with it. We can make slabs out of it, and they can go back together. We can make walls out of it. We can make bricks out of it. Look at that. Ooh, now that's pretty neat. I really like that block. I think that's pretty cool. Anyway, these are pretty specific blocks, meaning we actually use these in some recipes I found out by reading the Lexica Botania, and also living wood. So living wood is a nice, soft, velvety looking block. Now, I actually made my first flower, the pure daisy. I'll show you what these pure daisies do. So I made these little pads here, and we can throw our daisies down on dirt, right? Oh, see, it's sparkling already. There we go. And it doesn't have to be 8. You can actually stick just one. Oh, of course I wrecked that one. All right, and then these. Oh, and it's not wood. Jeez, I forgot. It's not planks. It's actual logs. We need logs. I have some logs right here. So logs get changed into... Oh, there goes. Awesome, right? Very cool. And I believe we'll see the same things happening right over here. So they just sit there for a little bit, and the magic from the flower penetrates into the surrounding wood, and it will eventually transform into the living wood blocks that we saw. Look at that. Very cool. All right, perfect. And then we can harvest them up. I made the flower pouch, and the flower pouch is almost like a backpack. So we can access it this way. I was doing some other research when I was reading about this. There we go. Oh, and it actually puts the colors on there. So we could have different colors, I suppose. Look at that, Wand of the Forest. I've got it right here. Now we can do a number of different things with this thing. It allows us to look at different blocks and rotate blocks and interact with them in different ways. So that's pretty cool. But the other thing is that Botania and Quark do actually incorporate a lot of functionality into dispensers and allow you to, I think we can put a wand inside of a dispenser. When it's activated with redstone, it acts like it's clicked. So we can do different things with that. We need some water for the Petal Apothecary, as it's called. So let's throw down this guy right here. So this is our Petal Apothecary, which we can see shooting there. Petal Apothecary, what you use to make flowers. So, and then we have to put, okay, that happens to me an awful lot. I guess I gotta look at the bottom there. Now, this thing will consume the water block that we have in there when we go to make flowers. So we wanna make endoflames because it will absorb any combustible items or blocks dropped on the nearby vicinity, which means we can drop wood, and we have plenty of wood here. So give me one of those and we'll throw that in there. Perfect. And then we'll throw in this one. And then we'll throw in a gray. Ready? There we go. Oh, see, now it gives us the formula. Now we know that we're good. It gives us that little plus symbol, and it just says we need seeds. So let's throw a seed in there. All right, see, it consumed the water. And electric magic. Wow, I don't know what that means, that we earned electric magic, but we also got this guy. The Endoflame. Let's just throw down our guy there, the Endoflame. The mana pool and the mana spreader. That's what we need. So let's do that. And that, great. We have a mana pool. So we can put that down right here. And let's put down, we need to make a spreader. Oh, it looks just like the, oh, okay. Wow, that's pretty cool. Now we do something with the bind mode. Oh, there we go. So now this is going to start filling up with mana because this is starting to fill up. This is sending mana into the mana pool. So we were able to bind it by shift right clicking with the Wand of the Forest. Now this guy. Let's give this guy some combustible items here. That's combustible, right? That's a piece of coal. Oh, it did it. Oh, that filled up nice and big. You saw that big pulse? Big pulse of mana right there. And I don't know what I'm looking at here. I don't know what the diagram is telling me. Obviously, it's the blue arrows pointing to the mana pool. Oh, it's filling up. Look at that. I guess that's mana. That's mana right there. Okay. Oh, this is pretty exciting. Dang, we gotta take a nap. I don't know what to do here. Let's feed all these guys some wood. Right? Oh yeah, they all just pick up from it. Okay, we can drop them all. Wow, let's do that. That's looking pretty rad. So I'm gonna let this go for a while these guys chew up this wood here. We're gonna go to the Nether because I'm gonna get some glowstone because there's something I wanna do that just looks amazing. This is an existing little thingy here. I just kind of dug out a little bit. So we're going to build it here and we will go visit the Nether and see if A, we can find a Nether fortress, and B, if we can get a hold of some blaze powder because that's what we really, really need. So let's do that. I haven't been to the Nether, so I had some quartz in one of my chests. That quartz came from the dungeon, from the roguelike dungeon. That's where that came from. Yeah, it was the blocks behind which they were hiding hidden spawners. All right, so we made it out of the Nether there. I did find a fortress, and I didn't die, which was actually surprising. And you can see I still got my 37 levels. So I did come through here, and let me pick up all this stuff here. Just see if there's anything here that we haven't secured yet. We put a flower in here, and we put two of those, two glowstone dust, and a mystical flower, and it turns it into a glimmering flower. And what the glimmering flowers do is, oddly enough, they will emit light just like a glowstone lamp. Apparently, that's what I am led to believe. So if we roll out here and we say, can we look at our F3 blocks? What do we got? Our light level. Light level 0, 1, 2. Now let's put a lamp, let's put a glimmering flower. 14. So this works just like a torch, right? No, it works just like a glowstone block. It is itself 15. Yep, at my feet, it's measuring light level 15. And on top of that, it will light up the area around it just like a torch or a piece of glowstone or a redstone lamp. Now that means we can decorate with these flowers and they will be actually functional and they will be lit. So we just have to check this out at night. I grabbed some grass I had picked up just arbitrarily with the shears at some point. Now I'm gonna drop these in here. Look at that, okay, so that's awesome. You got a little tool tip there. So what we're making here is something called pasture seeds. So let's throw those in there. All right, very cool. Let's do one of those and a pasture seed. No, is it the other way around? There we go. Now we have a floating cyan flower. So what does that do? Oh, look at that. And it's 15 on top of it, so it's up a block. It basically, so it's as if it's lighting as if there's a torch one block higher than this block. Let's do this. You're out of here, torch. You're old school. Oh man, I want to see what this looks like at night. Let's make a few more. And isn't that cool? They're providing light just like regular lamps. Let's make a couple more. Let's do one over here. Oh, wow, that's cool. And we don't have to put torches out. And they're floating. Of course, we can also just put the glimmering flower itself down. Like that. And we don't have to have torches everywhere. Oh, man, you know what this means, right? Decorative-wise. What this means for us as far as design aesthetic goes and our sort of elven elven fantasy builds and stuff. I mean, we don't have to have torches everywhere. We can literally just have flowers that have magical property effects, magical particle effects coming out, and they're actually going to be practical lighting for us. Oh, I just think this is the coolest thing. I just think these are so rad. Also, I of course have my brightness turned all the way up for video recording, so it doesn't look very dramatic. Let's make some string really quick because I want to see what it looks like if we can't tell that they're if they'll float on string. Yeah, that is pretty cool. It's like Harry Potter plants cruising around. Man, I kind of dig this. All right, well, this is just a mess of an episode, guys. I know we didn't do any building here. We did look at a few new blocks. We started our mana production a little bit just to see how it works. We've made some floating flowers that light everything up. All in all, I'm getting pretty excited about the possibilities that we can do things with the magic and stuff here. I will do some stuff in between episodes here to try to learn more about what we can do with these mana spreaders, this mana spreader and the mana pool, all that stuff, and see if I can't get us somewhere where we can actually do some building next episode, because this is, well, you know, partially adventure and learning the mods too. So hopefully it was okay, though. I know most of you want to see some building, and I definitely want to get there as well. I hope life is going well for you guys. Stay zen, think positive, and you know, even when the heavy stuff happens in life, there's still positivity out there somewhere. All right, guys, take care. This is CryinMo. I had a great time hanging out. See you guys very, very soon. Bye-bye.